there's somebody much smarter than myself who can speak Japanese and will help us all understand this interview. Corey. Everybody give Corey a round of applause.
Alright guys, thanks for coming out. As I'm sure some of you are aware, we have two legendary costume actors with us today. Mr. Nakajima. I guess when I was younger, I saw a lot of sort of historical films, historical fight battle scenes with a lot of stunt planes, and you know, I thought that was really cool and really interesting, and I wanted to get involved in that. You know, I was interested in sort of Sentai stuff like the Power Rangers and stuff where people would do daring sort of stunts and action things.
For Mr. Nakajima, how did you first get involved in the original Godzilla?
Nakajima-san, hajimete Gojira ni matsuwareta ryū wa dōui fū ni Gojira ni narimashita? So originally, sort of just as a test, a couple candidates moved around in some of the suits, and I was really one of the only ones that could actually move within the suit. And so it was pretty clear cut after that that I'd be the actor.
For Kitagawa, taking over the role of Godzilla in Godzilla 2000 Millennium, how did that become? How did you land that part? And second part of the question, what was it like assuming the role of that famous character?
ゴジラ2000をやるきっかけになったのは その前の年のモスラ3っていう番組の「キングギドラ」をやって監督の評価が良かったからやってくれと頼まれました。
So first of all, before that film, I had starred as King Ghidorah in Mothra 3, and the casting director for Godzilla 2000 was interested in my performance, and he asked me to take on the role.
で、それをやるのに準備として何をしてきましたか？いや、それは今まで自分がやってきた仕事の集大成ですから、ゴジラをするためにはあえて何の練習も Still nothing.
Well, you know, I'm a pro, so I didn't really have to do anything to prepare for that role.
For Mr. Nagajima, how much was the original Godzilla weigh and how tall was it?
あの、最初のスーツですね。 その身長高さと重量はいくらでしたか?
Right, so that suit, the height actually hasn't changed much over the years. It's just about 2 meters, but the weight was 100 kilograms.
What was it like moving around in the
suit? その 100 kilo の中に動くかとどういう感じでしたか?
Yeah, it was pretty hard to move around. Yeah, I mean, you know, nowadays we have the technology and the materials to produce much lighter suits, but at the time the war had just finished, so we didn't really have that much available. You know, it was an older period and we just didn't have access to a lot of technology, and so we had to, you know, really dig deep and kind of scrounge together the materials for that kind of suit, and it came out that heavy. So it definitely wasn't easy to shuffle around in the original Godzilla suit.
For both, what were some of the major challenges for each of you for portraying Godzilla?
2人ともに、ゴジラの役になるのに、一番まあ、チャレンジ、難しいところは何でした?
Yeah, like I said, the movement in general was difficult. I actually practiced judo when I was younger, and I think that was really the only reason that I was able to handle moving around. I think someone who doesn't do a lot of exercise wouldn't even be able to move in that suit. I think for me, it was the fact that the suit already had a face made for it, and so, you know, it can't really smile or make facial expressions. So when I took on the role originally, I thought a long time about how to make it expressive and how to make it show different emotions.
Yes.
So for Mr. Nagajima, can you talk about the suit and the progression through the films of, you know, did they make it any easier for him, how it became, you know, just through the years of technology?
Suits の進化、映画と映画の間に、まあ、その変えていった改造とか、それどういうふうに変えていきましたか?
Yeah, I mean, for me, I'm not as familiar or interested with the suit itself, But the people inside that suit, certainly there was a great deal of change over the years. You know, us at Toho, we consider ourselves to be the originals. And, you know, Godzilla went through a few different studios, but ultimately they all got axed. Because, you know, they weren't professional, they couldn't handle it. And so, you know, now we got someone that can actually, you know, over time we finally found someone that could really take on the role properly. And, you know, I think it's really more a matter of the people in the suits knowing the techniques and the way to make it work.
For Mr. Kitagawa, talk about, you know, Godzilla had some facial expressions. Was that you controlling them, or were there other people controlling that aspect of the monster?
さっき話しました、表情ですね。そういう、まあ、時々ゴジラがその自分でその表情ができるように、機能追加されましたから、それその表情は、あなたが、スーツの中に操作してたか、外部からの操作があったかどちらですか。それはもう外部の操作ですね。Yeah,
that was all controlled off screen by other people.
So, for both the gentlemen. To describe what it was like working with them on a very detailed nature sense.
え、外部で言えば、スーツの人じゃなく、他の人を考えると、やっぱミニチュアセットの中に、働くのがどういう感じでしたか? どちらの2人とも。
Yeah, you know, when I think about those miniature sets, it reminds me of a time period when there wasn't the internet, there wasn't a lot of computer technology available. Everything that was on the screen was a real thing. You know, at that time, our budget was so tight, and you know, everyone had to think, you know, creatively and be inventive and come up with ideas. And try them out, you know. It wasn't as easy as just saying like, well, let's shoot this and we'll try it out. And if it doesn't work, we'll cut it. Like, we didn't have enough of a budget to do that. So a lot of times, we would try something, and you know, it kind of worked. But it was your idea, it was your baby, and you know, you were so happy to see it on film. And then when the director says, well, we wanted to cut it, but we couldn't, you know, you're like, oh, thank God. And so, you know. I worked on Godzilla for a very long time, and you know, eventually it passed through so many hands, and the interest died out, and it was sort of, you know, it kept getting dropped over and over again, and then it seemed like, you know, out of nowhere, the interest started resurging again. Everyone became more interested in it. But, you know, being out of the loop for so long, the directors that were taking over, I had never heard of these guys. And, you know, when you talk to them and you say, like, are you looking at the old films? Are you watching them? And they always say, yes, I mean, they really demonstrated clearly that they had done their homework. And it's thanks to their proper taking the time to view the old films and appreciate all the work and craft that went into that, that the new films are coming out are working. What was the question? ミーチアセットなどの中に面白いところを、はい、面白いというか興味深いところですね。
いや、まあ日本の、日本、まあ、アメリカもそうでしょうけど、すごく本物のようにできているので、それを壊すときには、できているものをもう一回火薬を全部つけて、切り込みを入れて、それでまた元に戻して、それを壊すんです。だからそこに至るまでに3時間とかかかるから、そのみんなの努力を無駄にしないように頑張ったというところが面白いことですか？
Interesting things. Well, you know, I suppose the thing about miniatures is it takes so much time to build them up and make them look so realistic. You know, a lot of these sets that I've been working in, you know, it takes them 3 hours to get everything set up and get everything in place. And then in an instant, I just crush it. And, you know, if they don't get the shot, then they have to spend another 3 hours building the set again. So, you know, for me, it was a lot of pressure to not waste everyone's time putting those sets together. I mean, is that, would you guys consider that an interesting point?
Yeah.
For Mr. Nakajima, please describe the technique used to film in underwater scenes.
あの水中のシーンの中に何かコツはありましたか？
Yeah, I mean, it required a lot of technique. If you have trouble during a scene like that, it can be the end of everything. You know, I actually have scuba diving experience and knowledge, and I think that's sort of that's why I was able to do it.
What input did you have as far as the character in Godzilla and the choreography in the fight scenes?
ゴジラのキャラと、振り付けに自分なりの意見のは追加できましたか？入れることができましたか？
あ、いやもう自分ゴジラは自分で全部決めて歩く道数字は決まっているのであとは自分のやりたいようにやってました。
Well, yeah, I mean, really, I was in charge of almost everything as far as who Godzilla was when I was taking over. The path that I walked was set, but other than that, everything was up to me.
For both, on average, how long were you able to remain in the Godzilla suit before you had to take a break?
2人ともに平均スーツの中の時間はどれくらいありましたか？休憩まで。
Well, for me,
you know, it's just work. And when I'm working, I'm focused on my work. And so I didn't even perceive time. I mean, I feel like it could have been any length of time, and I'm sure it changed from take to take. But you know, I didn't even really take breaks. Breaks, as you guys would imagine, you can't really eat when you're working like that. And so I can't really say an average time.
中島さんの言われた通りカットによってその長さは違うんですけど、まあ大体特撮っていうのはこういうセットの着替えというかの舞台にビルを作っていって、最初は何もない、作っていくのにまあだから3時間4時間かかって、自分がスーツに入るのはその3時間、例えば3時間、それが短い時もありますよ。3時間後の入ったら 10秒で終わったりとか、そんな話です。出入りにまた時間かかるので、入るのにまあ20分ぐらいかかって、撮影して、パンってやって、終わって、出るのにまた15分ぐらいかかる。そんな感じ。Yeah,
what's funny is, I mean, you know, you have to imagine the shooting day, you know, you're up on this kind of stage with everything set up, and, you know, like I said, well, like Mr. Nakajima said, you know, you don't really think so much of the time in and out of the suit because it's all sort of a process. Like I said, the crew is setting up the stage for about 3 hours, and you know, before you are going to shoot your scene, you have to get into the suit, and that takes about 20 minutes or so. Then you shoot the scene, and it's like bam, and it's over. But then you have to take the suit back off again, and so I mean, obviously the shots vary in length. But you know, it's not really as cut and dry as like suit on, suit off, suit on, suit off.
So there's a lot of crossover between Godzilla and King Kong now. A lot of people make that comparison. Did the actors know, Mr. Nakajima, know why they didn't use stop motion and why they used live in suits?
ファンの作業の中に、ゴジラとキングコングの比較は 結構ありますが、キングコングに使われたストップモーションはなぜゴジラに使われてないのかな。Really, it's just, you know, the opinion of the director. You know, he just didn't like stop motion, didn't want to do it. Yeah, I think it may also just been part of the costume design that, you know, it worked better for that movie with stop motion, and for Godzilla it wouldn't really have worked out. I think there might have been some factors there as well.
For Mr. Kitagawa, when Godzilla 2000 Millennium was made, do you know why practical suit effects were used instead of going with the more popular CGI route?
2000 Millennium の時に、CGじゃなくて、普通の具体的な特撮にした理由は何でしょうか。いや、それはCGが元からではなくて、最初からスーツに入るスーツメーションの撮影の仕方がやっぱり日本では昔からあったから、CGがその後にできてきたっていうことです。Well, this, you know, what we call suit motion, that practice had been, you know, an ongoing craft in Japan for a long time leading up to that point. And I think because of that history, that's where we go first. We go to the suit first. And then after that, we think if, you know, CGI would work or not. And things start to become more CGI after that.
Both of the gentlemen as well. What is the difference while you're traveling around the world in fandom? US, Japan, and all the places you've been, what kind of difference do you notice in the fact?
あの、まあ、いろいろ国際的に移動してファンに会う機会があると思いますが、その中に日本人のファンと外国人のファンの中の違いはどういうふうに違いますか？
Yeah, you know, honestly, I would say that half and half, about half of the fans that I meet are the same, Japan or America. I think we're all looking at the same films, and we're all appreciating the same world, and we're all sort of part of the same group. We're all members of the same fandom, and you know, I really think it doesn't matter what country the Godzilla fan comes from. I think we're all part of this greater whole, and I did all this work with Tsuburaya and like the director and Honda, and the three of us really like worked together to create this new genre. And when I see the new works with the new directors, and I see their faces and the fans' faces, and I think that everyone is sort of studying the same material, and so it's all sort of being passed down. And I don't think it matters much which culture people come from. My answer might be a little different from Nakajima's, and so he might get a little mad at me, but...
To put it
straight, I mean, Americans, their passions burn hot. And, the American fans, they make their presence known. I think there's probably more of them than the Japanese fans, but when I compare the Japanese Godzilla fans to the American Godzilla fans, the Japanese are much quieter and reserved and down key, and the Americans are hot.
Mr. Nakajima, tell us about filming of Seven Samurai and the challenges of working on a Kurosawa film.
Nakajima-san, 7 Samurai に働いて、黒沢さんとというやり取りは、どういう感じでしたか?
Yeah, I mean, Kurosawa is mainly a period drama director, samurai era, and I think with that comes a certain level of, strong-headedness, and so we butted heads a little bit, where he said you have to stay focused on
Chidaigeki on period dramas. And I told him, well, I'm working on one right now. And he's like, no, you have to stay with this student, you have to stay with this. And you know, we butted heads a little bit on that.
Mr. Kitagawa, he actually joined the Japan Action Club in 1975. Could he talk about his work there and just about Japan Action Club?
What year was that?
Okay. 1975年に Japan Action Club にあの入りました。そういう体験のあの話はしてくれますか。体験というかあの思い出がシチュエーション。
いやまあ、自分はあのパワーレンジャーになりたかった、そしてウルトラマンになりたかったから、その年にジャパンアクションクラブに入りました。でもなれませんでした。
Well, like I said originally, you know, I wanted to be a Power Ranger and I wanted to be Ultraman, so I joined Tokyo Action Club, but it never happened.
まだ時間あるよ。
Yeah,
no. No, I don't have time.
All right, final two questions for these gentlemen, and then we'll wrap it up. First one, what are your thoughts on the American Godzilla movies?
あと2つの質問ですけど、まずは、アメリカのゴジラの映画はどう思いますか？Well, I think that movie, I have kind of an issue with the story. Right. And when you start with a poor story, everything else kind of comes out of that. So, I mean, regardless of how the actors did, it's sort of, you know, it's all requisite from that story. I loved it.
トライスターゴジラはちょっとあれでしたけど、トライスター最初の1998年のゴジラはちょっとかわいそうだったけど見てて。
Yeah, I mean, I love American Godzilla, and especially like TriStar from 98. You know, I think it kind of gets a bad rap, and I recommend everyone go watch it.
ギャレス・ゴジラはすごくヒーローみたいでかっこよくて好きです。
Yes.
あの、の前の。
Yeah, and Yaris Godzilla, I think he's really cool, with like a cool hero, and so I mean, I'm super into it.
And then the final question is, why do you think Godzilla has been popular for as many years all over the world?
二人ともに、世界中あのいろいろな人間あの何年間ゴジラの興味があの継続しています。それはなぜでしょうか？Yeah, I mean, I don't really know, but I think that, you know, people grow up and they see something that they like, and they're interested in it, and they hold that interest, and, you know, they want to make something like that, and they continue on, and I think, you know, if it goes well, that's great. If it doesn't go well, then, you know,
they shouldn't have, you know, I think it has to, they have to do a good job at least with it, you know, because where I started, if it didn't go well, it was over. You just get crushed. So that's how I feel about that.
それは、アメリカは大きいものっていうのはキングコングが最高ですよね。で、生きている、今現在いる動物が大きくなっているのがアメリカ。日本は空想で作ってるもの、怪獣映画としては世界で初めて、中島さんがされたゴジラが初めてのものだから、あれを超えるものはできないからみんな好きなんじゃないですかね。
With America, you know, you have King Kong, and King Kong is sort of a beast that grew, you know, to huge proportions. And I think, you know, that's like, that's representative of America. And, you know, for Japan, Godzilla kind of came out of the sea. Godzilla is something that, you know, from Nakajima's era, that was created, you know, from the mind, like we invented it. And it was this concept that really stood the test of time, and I think that people nowadays are thinking, you know, like, are we going, can we make something bigger and better than that?
America は武器で怪獣を殺すけど、ゴジラは何を使ったの？死なないから、寝るだけで。
You know, I think in America, we always think of like destroying the monster with weapons. But the thing about Godzilla is it never dies. It only goes to sleep and then reemerges another day.
Everybody, please put your hands together.